Hey everybody, it's CapNex24 bringing you another part of Let's Play Legend of Zelda Spirit Tracks, and it's boss fight time again. This boss is pretty cool, and actually makes good use of both screens, as you can clearly see. Some weird thing in the water up there. Take your whip. You can go up there. Pretty easy, to be honest. There'll be a few of these weird, nasty tentacles. What you gotta do is take a spike. Hope that does not happen. And then fling it at the eye. Let's see, I have a potion, so I should be absolutely fine. Although I shouldn't even need the potion anyway. We're almost up to the boss, and truth be told, it's not that difficult, the boss. Like I mentioned in a previous episode, some guy discovered how to beat it in two phases. And it's really easy. You need the bombs, though. But anyway, here's the boss. Phytops, the Barbed Menace. Pretty cool boss, in my opinion. Just pounds away with his tentacles. What you gotta do, as you can see, there's obviously like pink spots all over his head. These pink, I don't even know what they are. Take your whip, grab a spike, throw it at one of those pink spots. There we go, uncover his eye, grab your whip, grab a spike, and throw it at his eye again. There we go. Do some spin attacks. That ought to do some damage. There, he'll pound you a bit. And rinse and repeat. He'll get more difficult, of course. He'll attack more. Give you a little bit less time. Still pretty easy. I think we've almost got him down. The trick to beating him in two phases is like using just the right combination of attacks. Include some bombs. Whatever. Spin attacks will still do the job well. You can see, obviously, he is attacking you with his other tentacles now. Oh, wow, fourth phase. Huh. I thought normally I could get him down in three. Doesn't really matter. He's not exactly difficult. Plus, there's hearts all over. I seem to be getting a lot of hearts from his, tentacles, I guess. There we go. One more spike, and that should just about finish him for good. That's just cheap. There we go. Last hit, and he's dead. He is gone. Fight is over. And we get another one of these things that I guess is supposed to be like a force gem. It's purple. I don't know, it's like a bluish purplish color. We get the symbol of the ocean temple. And of course that thing again, as we always do. And that rests right there in the pedestal. There we go, that's it for the dungeon. Spirit tracks are being restored. And it leads the line back to the Tower of Spirits, where we're going to need to go next. There we go, another part becomes reattached. Very nice, very, very nice. Alright, Ocean Rail map started glowing. We got some tracks leading to the Tower of Spirits. And as far as I know, well, besides the heart container, of course, that's all we need to do here. And so, that, guess let's get going. And I suppose that's it for this episode. So if you liked it, please rate, comment, subscribe. I'll see you guys next time.